Hey! How are you, fella?
Yeah, alright.
Alright, well, yeah, it's a bit rough, isn't it?
You need to see beyond the rubbish and see the scope of the vision, what we can do with it.
Okay.
For starters, look at it at the back. I mean, it's nice and spacious. We've got a load of room. Engine is housed in here. And if you have a good look at it,
it's
diesel. It's incredibly refined.
It's seen many, many better years.
You can hear this van coming in another county. So obviously it needs quietening down. It needs a service on the engine. Uh-huh. But it's all right. It goes. Bit of damage here. But I've seen you repair these before breakfast,
well,
slide hammer,
can be done, lots of filler.
But think about it.
It's pretty straight.
A side-opening sliding door, huge amount of space. Open it. I've never used it before. And there's a job for you.
Thanks, mate. Well, it's good to warn me anyway.
If you can get that fixed, that'd be great.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't work, obviously, it falls off. And I don't know how it goes, but we can have a go at manhandling it back on.
Slip it in there.
Hang on. There you go. That'll do for now. So, anyway, yeah, that needs to be fixed. There's a little bit of rust around it, but, you know, we could do something funky with a paint job, maybe.
Yeah.
Tyres look good. A little bit of a dent on the front. The VW badge is missing. Maybe we can, I don't know, get another one of them from somewhere and tidy up the front a bit. A little bit of rust around the side here.
Okay.
But nice, you know, it's the bumper's missing at the back, but we don't worry too much about it. But I've got a great idea for this, Ed.
Okay.
Think glitter ball. Think comfy cushions.
Okay, think passion wagon.
Think passion wagon.
That's
right. Okay. Drop down DVDs, maybe. I don't know how far we can go with it, but I really feel that we could turn this into a motorhome for me and you to go and have a bit of fun in before we get rid of it. Because whoever buys it from us is going to be incredibly proud after you fiddle with it and turned it into the chintz palace it deserves to be.
And it does really need a bit of help, so that'd be cool. So I can do anything I like.
Anything within our restrictive budget, but yes, it'd be nice if you surprised me, Ed.
I could do that.
Way!
Oh, yes! I've just driven this tatty and thoroughly unloved van back here to the workshop, and frankly, the experience nearly poisoned me. I had to drive most of the way with my head out of the window because the exhaust system was leaking so much it was filling the cab up with fumes. Now, I'm not going to mess about. My first job is to replace the exhaust system in its entirety. Now, all the bolts holding this exhaust in place are as rusty as the exhaust itself. Now, the problem with that is, things like where we've got a bolt here coming out of the turbo, if I snap it, because it won't actually budge, then it's going to give me a whole load more work to do. So a little spray of penetrating fluid should make my life a bit easier. Now, while that penetrating fluid is doing its stuff, I'm going to have a go at the less rusty bolts. Okay, well, here's our plug. And you can see it's actually not a spark plug with your cathode and your anode where your spark bounces around. It's actually a glow plug. Now, the reason it's called a glow plug is very simple. It's because it actually glows red hot. And I can show you a little experiment I prepared earlier. This is a jump pack, very nice, easy supply of 12 volts. Here's a nice new glow plug, and I just connect these two together. 12 volt goes through, and look at that, loads of current and a lovely glowing tip on the end of the glow plug. One old fan belt, one new fan belt. Well, the last thing I have to do in the service is the oil change. And of course, along with that will be the oil filter. But first of all, I need to start up the engine and make sure the oil is nice and warm. Well, the engine's nice and warm now, so I'm ready to dump the oil. So I'm just going to go and turn it off. While this is draining, I'm going to take off the oil filter. I'm just going to fill up the oil filter a little bit before I put it onto the car. And a little bit of oil around the seal. Well, the glow plug certainly made a big difference to starting the engine, and now all the other service items are done, this car is going to run like a dream. You know, I don't like the feel of this van, so I'm going to cut a hole in the door for a window to make it a lot less builder's van and a bit more camper van. Okay, well, the window is going to go here. I've actually got like a bit of board in the way first. I need to remove that to see what I'm actually going to have to cut through. I need to first of all work out where I want the window to sit, so I'm just going to get that into position, and then I'm going to take some measurements, draw a little sketch so I know where the hole has to be on the other side of the window, and then the next stage is to mask up and start cutting away all this metal I need to discard. Very simply, I just had some measurements to locate the window on this side. So I had a measurement from this side, from that side, and from the top. So I'm just going to draw those on, place the window into position. Now, I'm pretty happy that my measurements are working out here. The window looks square in the door, which, of course, is very important. So my next job is actually to mark out the hole for the window. Well, it's looking pretty good. The window is in the rubber, and the rubber is now in the door aperture. Only thing I have to do now is lock it in position with a special beading. And to actually make this thing go into position better, I'm going to use a special tool. Look at this. We now have a window in our camper van door. It's fantastic. Loads of light. It's going to be a pleasure to camp in here.
Click here to subscribe.